Welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how I achieved this look, and it's just playing around with makeup, my tricks, how I like doing my things. I know it's a little bit different from every other makeup artist. Just let's watch the real thing. So I'm going to start with my primer. Don't forget to apply primer on your neck. And because I wear glasses, I apply more primer on this, the bridge of my nose, because I want to apply makeup and it doesn't move. My best part, because I enjoy doing my skin a lot more than any other makeup. When your skin looks good, your makeup looks better, fire. So I'm using this corrector, Kiss Beauty one. On YouTube, I've seen people using red lipstick. I don't know how effective that is. But yeah, use whatever you have. If you have red lipstick, do that. If it works for you, well and good. I'm looking down because my mirror is down here. Then I pick a brush and put it in. Then when you're done, pick a beauty blender. And remove any excess product, because we also don't want you having a red face. Then we set everything with powder. My powder is Sasha. And set it. We don't want it to move. Thank you. Then now I use my favorite foundation, Fit Me. My shade is 330. That's enough. Then I use a brush, but first I apply. Don't rub your product. Just pat. This method has helps in full coverage, because when you rub, it's like you're removing product from your face, so, and you don't want to remove, you just want everything to stay where it is. Don't forget under your eyes. Under your eyes. Then on your neck. Forehead. With how much coverage you want, you can add where your problem areas are. Mine is here because I have dark spots there. Then after that, you take your damn beauty blender. And try to push everything in. Fit Me, but my Fit Me is over, so I love this thing so much. Sasa natafutilia tu. I don't know why I don't have a brighter foundation. Because if you have a foundation that is lighter than your actual shade, you can actually use it. But I'll just use this illegal one. It can also do the job. Then on my chin, my nose. Like that, then on my forehead. That's why I like it. I like a brighter one. This one is so close to my shade. But I'm just trying to make it look. So I don't blend it right away. I just give it time. I just give it time to set. But as I wait, I use a darker foundation to contour my face and bring back color to this face, because I know it just doesn't look real, just look white, and we don't need that. And definitely my nose, but that we will do late, can do the job easily. So you just do that. I like doing my contour before I like doing my contour before I push in the corrector, because most of the time when I apply my contour, I overdo it and I need to like correct it. Like that. Go in. Trying to remove maybe harsh lines or parts that are not blended well enough. Like that. Then now we can blend my concealer. So I normally blend it outwards like that. Then on my forehead, I like that. Then after doing that, I pick my foundation brush. It's a flat brush, and just go in again. Try to blend everything together.
Then if you don't have a dark foundation, but you have an eyeshadow, this one is Rude and it's matte. Most of the, what are they called? The colors in here are matte. So sometimes I use
pink Kidogo product, not a lot. Then I go in again. Because a girl likes her face looking a bit colorful, so. I love contouring my face, I really do. But don't overdo it. When you overdo it, now it looks crazy. It doesn't look good. Looks crazy. So like that. Then I add on my nose. Something like that. Then again, I pick my foundation brush and push everything in, and my beauty blender, my wet beauty blender, and just try to blend everything in together. Forgive my voice, I have a cold. My favorite powder right now is the RCMA. It's so good. It's a no color powder. Then when you apply this, they say, okay, so at the back it looks like this. Come on, okay. Yeah, it looks like that. So at the back, the perfect universal settings powder for all skin types. No color powder, contains absolutely no pigment, no perfume, no fillers, and will never alter your foundation shade or natural skin tone. It will set your makeup with a flawless finish that won't cause flashback. So a little goes a long way. Don't overdo it, because when you overdo it, it won't look as good as we want it to. And I'm not so like that. I'm not a fan of baking, so I don't bake my powder, because I don't know, I'm just scared that maybe when I bake I'll just look ashy and don't look the way I want it to, so just avoid that step. The only time, because I wear spectacles, I bake on the ends of where my spectacles will fall. Because when you wear spectacles, you don't want your makeup moving. Then I use my Sasha to... The only place I set is this. Yeah, so that my contour can be visible. And also don't set for so long, because as I said, I don't want to look ashy, so... That, so as we wait for that powder to set, so beautiful. So I pick, oh my god, you take a fluffy brush, my brushes are dirty, I need to wash them, and I will. Then I'm going to use this shade right here. Okay.
So you keep applying the color that you want. Then I go with a darker color because I don't know, I'm just going to go with. So I think I'm going to use this darker color.
Thank you.
So I'm happy with what I have. Now I can remove this.
So I'll put my eyeliner then and my lashes, then I'll come back because I can't do those two things on camera.
I'll come back. I'll put my lashes.
I use two setting sprays, this is MAC and this one. I first start with this one. Ah, use whatever you have, it will work. Use it and save some coins like that. Then I spray my MAC. The MAC one is to set everything together. Feels amazing. If you've reached this far, if you like the makeup look, please like, share, and subscribe. I'm sorry, my voice is a little bit low, and it's because I have a cold. I also want to thank everyone who has liked, who has shared all my videos. Thank you very much. I don't take it for granted. Thank you. I don't know what to say.